Hello, everyone, and welcome to Art Smart. Today we're going to talk about a book called The Disney Films, and it is a book by Leonard Maltin. This is a book that has had many different editions over the years. I actually have the first edition here from 1973, and I'm sorry, the Fort Worth Public Library, but whoever chucked this book out never checked it back in. But I have the book now. It was given to me as a gift. Leonard Maltin made this book, or wrote this book, in the 1970s to start because he realized a lot of people had not taken the Disney films very seriously when it came to a critical eye. And he wanted to look at the Disney films more critically, say how they have changed American culture, how they've changed film themselves, and actually just looking at the films themselves and saying which ones are good, which ones are not so good on a critical level. I think it was a very interesting premise in the 1970s. The thing is, now we are in 2017, and books like this really are not necessary anymore. Virtually every film gets plenty of coverage. We have things like Rotten Tomatoes, and we have all kinds of books that have been made discussing how Disney has changed American culture and how much culture has affected Disney. So it is no longer a novel concept. So reading a book like the Disney films feels kind of like a time machine, going back in time to a time where not so much information was out there, and people looked at the Disney Corporation in a very different way. I find this book interesting in that way. While I do think this is a pretty decent critical book, he does admit in it that he has a hard time separating his love for the company from the films themselves. And so sometimes he's maybe being a little generous to the films. But despite that, though, I think he does a pretty good job of picking the films apart, saying this is good, this is not so good. And he takes you up, in this particular edition, he takes you up through the movie Robin Hood. After that, obviously, other editions talked about other Disney films. I think he did a pretty decent job of breaking the films down, even if he wasn't quite as harsh on certain films as he could have been. But as I was stating earlier, I think the most interesting thing about this book, though, is it gives us an idea of how these films were viewed in something like the 1970s. Disney has become such a huge cultural icon over the last few decades that in the 1970s, it was interesting to see the Disney company as it was starting to kind of fall apart. And it did not have the same cultural relevance that the company does now. So I think it's kind of interesting in a whole different way when you look at it through that kind of time machine lens. And so I do think that I would recommend this book. It's not the most serious critical book I've ever read, and I think he's a little bit too much of a homer to take some of the things he says super seriously. I trust some other critics maybe a little bit more when it comes to their criticism of the Disney films, but he does a decent job, and the book itself is just an interesting look at the company in general and just a reflection on how much our culture has changed, especially when it comes to the influence of Disney over the last couple of decades. So I definitely would recommend just giving it a look if you're at the library or something. I don't know if I would say that you should spend money to go and get this. Anyway, hopefully this helps you to make a decision or to not make a decision to buy a book. Hopefully it makes you a little bit more art smart, and hopefully you'll come back for more of these film and book reviews. Have a great day, everybody.